gathered together from the cosmic reaches of the universe, here in this great hall of justice, are the most powerful forces of good ever assembled. Dedicated to truth, justice, and peace for all mankind.
Hey everybody, welcome back to the Spinner Rack. It is Mars here, and today I'm going to tell you some sad news for some of those who like this Amazon show, The Peripherals. So that show was basically a show about how someone from the future was able to communicate with someone from the past using, I wouldn't say a video game, but I guess in essence a video game. You know, how the world in the future was changed. Again, because of what happened in the past, we have the main character. What happened to her in the past helps to affect what happens in the future. And because of her interaction with the future, it changes. You know, this is one of the problems I'm going to tell you right now with time travel. Right now, because of the whole multiverse thing with Disney and we've just had a confluence, I can't say, a ridiculous amount of multiverse impacts on the future, time travel back and forth. And you know what? I watched the show. I was interested in it. I was willing to give it another thing, but it is confusing. And you know, let me tell you one thing. When you're gonna do a show like this, you gotta make it as basic for most people. Most people don't have the patience to sit down and watch and say, wow, this is what's happening with the world. Yes, you know, you have to change it up a little bit. I thought some of the action scenes were really good. I thought some of the characters, many of the characters were very strong. But it's a whole convoluted process that sometimes you need to streamline to get the general viewers. Amazon is not as widely seen or spoken about their shows as something like Netflix, right? Or even, I guess, Netflix after Netflix, the number two is probably Disney Plus or whatever. You need to do something to stand out, right? And the last thing you need to do is make it more confusing than it needs to be, you know? The show looked beautiful. It had a lot of money behind it. You could definitely tell Amazon put a lot of stuff into it. They tried to explain this. I think this was a small story. I can't remember the author who wrote it, but I think, was it Philip K. Dick? I'm not sure, but it was just too much. And I think that there was possibilities that you needed to move the story a little faster. The premise was not a bad premise, but I think that what happened to the world in the future, where it's basically run by gangsters, got a little crazy, where the world has these gigantic statues that are used as filters because of the, I guess, the radiation where the world got destroyed. I think threw a lot of people off. Simplify it, you know. There's great premises on a lot of these shows, and you know, keep it simple. Try to get people into it, then probably have a twist. You know, of course, I'm not a movie director, I'm not a TV show producer or a showrunner or whatever, but I'm just trying to tell you this simple thing from being a viewer. You know. I enjoyed the premise. The actors were decent. I like how they attacked it, but I think as long as it kept on going through, it got a little bit more involved that it didn't need to. The question we always need to start off, is it story or is it the technology behind it, you know? And I think it's the story and the acting that might make the most important impact. You know, you gotta get good actors who can understand the story and drive it forward. But you need a story that people can understand. Yes, you know, you can have the most complicated book in the world. There's going to be a segment to like it. But if you're going to spend hundreds of millions of dollars or tens of millions of dollars, you got to make sure damn well that, you know, it's within a particular, you need a certain amount of size of people to watch it, you know. And I think that, you know, let's go back to the shows back in the 90s, where you had those hour-long TV shows, sci-fi shows such as, you know, Star Trek, the Next Generation, Star Trek, Voyager, Star Trek, Deep Space Nine, you had Babylon 5, you had Kevin Sorbo's Hercules and Xena and stuff like that. You know, those were hour-long shows. You know, that they were able to keep the budget down and also entertain a certain amount of people. Yeah, I understand now you need a larger budget now to get people in. But if it's so large that you can't really tell your story, you need two or three seasons, you need to bring that down and focus on the audience that you really want to capture as soon as you can. A lot of these shows now, you know, you're basically film all 6 to 10 episodes and it's in the can already, so you can't even make any adjustments afterwards. Like in the old days where you have like 22 episodes and let's say halfway through the season or a third way through the season, you realize, hey, you know what? This isn't really working. Let's change or something like that. Once these shows are in the can, they're in the can until you go to the next season. So I get upset that Peripheral lost out. Like I said, it had a pretty unique vision and stuff like that. But I understand why, you know, Amazon isn't making that particular bet anymore. Like I said, you know, we got to try to tell these stories. We have to tell good stories that are acted well to get people to come in and watch it, you know? So, hey, Spinnerack out. See you later.